I got it! I got it!
Hello. Yes? Yes? Sweet mother of double jeopardy backstroking and butterscotch. We're on our way.
Who was it? The Girl Scouts lawyers again?
That was the commissioner. You'll never guess which unduly famous TV personality made the most wanted criminals list this week.
Phyllis Diller? Gavin McLeod? Wink Martindale?
Close. Myra Stump, the darling hawk of daytime talk.
Myra? As in America's mom? The woman who told Tom Hanks to get a haircut? Surely you jest.
She's holding her audience hostage and giving them valuable gifts against their collective will.
I don't normally endorse the use of the word dastardly, but this is clearly dastardly. I think.
We've got to drive over to the station right away, or at our earliest convenience.
Great! I've been itching to bust some skulls since they canceled my so-called life.
Hello! Welcome back to Let's Play Sam and Max. And this is Series 1, Save the World, Episode 2, Situation Comedy. So, without further ado...
Sam, it's me. Open the window. I'm trapped on the ledge again.
Welcome back, America, to day 3.5 of my most special episode ever. You don't want to miss any of our exciting guests coming up this hour. Plus, everyone in the audience is going to be getting a lifetime supply of non-dairy creamer!
We don't need non-dairy creamer. We need sleep.
Oh, I see. You were all thrilled when I gave you cars, then all expense paid vacations, and then home entertainment centers. But now, after I worked so hard and sacrificed so much, you'd rather sleep? It's all about you, isn't it? I guess nothing I ever do is good enough for you.
Maybe. Maybe we'll start using non-dairy creamer. Someday.
That's more like it. You see, there's lots more fun to come, so stick around, America, and sit up straight. Nobody trusts a sloucher.
Good old TV. It's the only way I still feel well-adjusted.
My toes are all a-twitter that we've gotten another case so close on the heels of the last one.
Don't say a-twitter, Sam.
Well, well, Myra Stump holding her audience hostage. You watch that particular bit of daytime fluff occasionally, don't you, Max?
Whenever our TV's out of hock, for some reason I can't get enough of her sharp-toothed maternal ranting.
Why do you suppose Myra's got her audience captive?
Who knows? Last month, Charles Grodin put his hand on her desk, and she hit it with a ruler. She's very strict.
You're a lovable but essentially useless lump of fur and icky stuffing materials, Max.
On the contrary, I can be a vital source of alternative insight into the problems that plague you.
Well, there's that. Let's get going.
You lead, and I'll follow haphazardly, shall I?
Right. Let's get down to the TV studio and see what's happening.
Where are we going, Sam?
The TV studio.
Goody!
Well, here we are, Max. The TV station with programs too old to be contemporary, too new to be retro, but consistently derivative enough to be popular. WARP.
Television's so mindless, you can't help but watch.
Oddly quiet in here.
Mysteriously so.
Well, let's find this Myra character and smack some good old-fashioned sense into her.
I don't care if we smack it into her or smack it out of her, just so long as there's smacking involved.
You crack me up, little buddy.
Well, the transitions into new areas seems to make the engine a bit glitchy, it seems.
Need a broom, little buddy?
I don't use brooms, Sam. I necessitate the use of them.
I hope that's just a prop.
I hope it isn't!
There's only one explanation for a propeller on the wall.
Yes, this TV station is a giant flying battleship!
Either that, or it's just a prop. Get it?
I vote for the giant flying battleship.
It's got a falling star on it.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder how you'll crash and burn.
Yeah.
Well, I kind of like Max's voice in the last episode, but it seems to have gone pretty off in this one so far.
The Barrel Haven. From whence comes this storybook set?
Clearly from a work of unparalleled artistic vision and emotional expressiveness.
No wonder I haven't seen it. Hey, even the scaffold is just a prop.
Yeah, from that show about the TV crew that solves crimes around the station using advanced forensics and overly dramatic reenactments?
Come on, who ever heard of a crime at a TV station? Stand aside, casually attired stagehand. We're Sam and Max, freelance police.
We've come to save some pathetic hostages from the clutches of...
Okay, I'm gonna stop you right there. Number one, I'm not a stagehand. I am the director. The director!
Could a fool...
Number two, we're no longer holding the auditions for animal cops with crippling mental disabilities and a lust for dance.
Oh no, we're not actors.
You got that right. I don't think I've ever seen worse acting in my entire life. And yes, I have seen Keanu Reeves' performance in Toast, the musical.
Sam, I think my hypersensitive ego may need stroking.
Don't look at me.
Next! Who's next?
You don't seem to understand. We're highly untrained police officers.
Look, hats off for dedication, guys, but I'm just not buying the police act.
I feel so invalidated.
We're looking for Myra Stump, the darling hawk of...
Do not mention that name in my presence.
Which name? Myra or Stump?
Either and or both.
What's your beef with Myra?
Let's just say Myra and I have creative differences. I'm creative and she isn't. I'm sorry, what was your question?
You and Myra. Why the hate?
Look, Myra runs her show her way, and I run every other show my way. If she doesn't want me on her set, I could care less.
You mean you couldn't care less. If you could care less, then you do care some, which doesn't really...
No, I was right. I could care less, because I care even less about what you're saying right now.
Oh, burn!
Quiet, knucklehead. What are you doing here, anyhow?
What am I doing here? I'm holding auditions for Midtown Cowboys. What are you doing here?
Midtown Cowboys? The critically panned but publicly adored sitcom about two cattle ranchers trying to make it in Midtown Manhattan?
Yes, well summarized.
You're hiring extras?
No, I'm hiring the stars. The two main characters went on Myra a couple days ago and I haven't heard from them since. I need replacements ASAP.
Sam, did you hear that? If we can pass one lousy audition, sitcom stardom will finally be ours!
Rocketing to fame for the most insubstantial of reasons. That truly is the American dream.
Do people really say ASAP? I guess in Britain it's more ASAP, but never mind. Something very inconsequential, but never mind.
We'd like to apply for that instant stardom you promised?
You want to audition? Well, if there were anybody else here, I'd tell you to forget it, but okay.
All right! What do we do?
I'm going to have you play a scene from Old Yeller. Tell me you've seen it.
I'm not into horror movies.
It's the classic boy gets dog, dog gets rabies, boy shoots dog story. Max, I want you to play the boy.
Yes! Boy! That is so me.
And Sam, you play the dog.
Oh.
Okay, Sam, ready? I need you to act like you've got full-blown rabies. Understand?
What's my motivation?
You're a mad dog! Now, show me, rabbit! No, Digdy! You should be just frothing mad!
We didn't really bring anything with us.
What are you doing? Sorry, I'm not hiring a dog who can't even do a simple rabidity scene.
I don't know what went wrong. I was feeling so rabid.
You look pretty disease-ridden to me.
Come back after you've taken a few thousand acting lessons.
Right, there isn't much we can do here. But there's still two people back near the office we can speak to.
Hey! Actors only back there.
But we're police.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Once used for apples, now used for derrieres.
No, that's about it. Let's go back. Right. Bosco first, then we speak to Sybil. After this initial walking scenes, I will cut some future.
What the?
You're probably wondering how I know your names.
Not really.
Psst, it's me, Bosco.
How would we ever have guessed that? He's even got the name tag on still.
What's with the slanted soup strainer, Bosco?
Bosco? I know not that moniker. I am Lord Reginald Rumpelbottom, Earl of Dukedom the Third.
Sam, what language is he speaking?
I'm not sure, Max, but I think it might be English. No, really, what made you convert to British?
It's because everybody's got an in for me, that's why!
Yeah, we heard.
I had to get a disguise to throw them off the trail. Oh, they'll never find me now.
They wouldn't even know where to begin to look.
Clever clogs.
Well, Max used the term British. We tend to sort of split them up into English. The Scottish aren't too keen about being called British. But anyway.
What sick forces of evil are bedeviling you this time?
It's the skin bodies, man! They're after me!
Skin bodies? Sounds like a pack of belligerent nudists.
Oh no. The skin bodies are like skinheads, but 10 times worse!
Sure they're not 100 times worse?
Yeah, maybe 100 times, maybe 1,000,000!
These skin bodies, what exactly are they doing to you?
They're stealing my shaving cream!
Of all the things of yours they could pinch, why the shaving cream?
So they can shave their bodies, of course.
Of course. Not to be rude, but why isn't your fancy pants defense system stopping these skin bodies?
Well, after the whole video delivery conspiracy, I figured I better build something to keep people from bringing stuff into my store.
So?
So, I needed to borrow some of the high-tech detecting parts from BTAS.
Meaning nothing stopping people from taking stuff out of the store anymore.
Dash it all! I knew I forgot something!
We want to buy something.
Quite so.
Yeah, okay.
Do you have any complimentary fresh garlic?
Nope.
Do you have any fine leather jackets?
Nope.
Do you have any gumballs the size of your head?
Nope.
Do you have any +2 plate armor of limitless squeezability?
Nope.
Do you have any Pez dispensers with the head of infamous Mexican revolutionary Pancho Villa?
Nope.
Do you have any ketchup?
Nope. Oh, wait.
Got you.
Blast! Drat! Dash it all!
Do you have any complimentary fresh...
Nope.
Okay, that was pretty short compared to the last one.
What have you got?
Well, there is still one kind of shaving cream the blooming skin bodies haven't got yet.
Oh, yeah, I love shaving.
That's funny. I've never seen you shave.
I didn't mean myself.
And I have a most peculiar device behind the counter.
What peculiar device are you so eager to pawn off on us this time?
It's the latest in Bosco tech innovation. A delightful invention I like to call a chemical-based voice modulator.
Voice modulator? What's that?
I do believe it's self-explanatory.
We don't really have time to explain it to ourselves. Why don't you just explain it to us?
Well, it alters the frequency of your voice molecules. Very useful, very useful.
We'd like that voice modulator.
That will be 30 shillings.
Yeah, I left our shillings in my other pants. How much in dollars?
Let's see here. 30 shillings would be about 1 million American dollars.
$1 million? No way are we giving out that many tickets.
I think we'll have to find an entirely new revenue stream if we want that voice modulator.
Worth every shilling, trust me, trust me.
Maybe we should try eBay.
We'll take your last can of shaving cream, old chap.
Splendid, spiffy, tickety-boo. Just bring it to the counter.
Nothing for us right now.
Indeed.
Hands in the air, Bosco. You're coming with us.
Good heavens! What is the meaning of this?
We're taking you in for masquerading as a man of class and distinction.
What the devil? Surely you jest.
Yes, surely we do. On the bright side, now you can add the police to your long list of paranoia-induced nightmare subjects.
Pshaw, piffle, pishwash.
Thanks, Bosco.
Pip, pip, honey nut cheerio.
Sludgies. This week's flavors, bangers and mash.
That's sausages and potatoes to you Yanks.
Oh, good. For a second, I thought it was something disgusting.
Nachos.
They're mine. Nachos.
Oh, God.
Whipped liverwurst.
Want some?
Absolutely not.
Anything else new?
Chilled and preserved fluids.
I wonder if Bosco used the fluid sample I submitted.
I hope not.
Right, let's get the shaving cream.
What do we have here? Organ Trader? Self-Loathing Weekly? Hot Bunny?
Ooh, let me see that.
Hot Bunny?
No, Self-Loathing Weekly.
I could use a shave.
I'll say. Your 5 o'clock shadow goes clear to your ankles.
Paws off, Dan! Dog! Pig dog! The skin bodies rule the streets!
Blah! Bugger! Blimey! Bollocks! The little bladder did it again! After him! I mean... Tally-ho! Tally-ho, fool!
Right, time to get into the DeSoto. I'm surprised they slipped bugger and bollocks into the dialogue. I thought this was a somewhat kind of family game, but oh well.
Where are we going, Sam?
Hey!
The skin buddies hit me, Sam!
After those rats! Do those laughably small wheels move so fast?
You'll never catch us! The skin body can't be stopped!
Take the wheel, little buddy.
I thought you'd never ask!
Can't dodge my shots forever!
Gotcha! The skin body can't be stopped!
Cheer up, man!
The skin bodies can't be stopped!
Hey, the shaving cream!
Okay, hold on tight, little buddy.
Mommy!
Well, that went quicker than expected. The aim was to shoot the rats into the... Oh, you saw what happened.
This place used to be Lefty's tool rental shop.
Good old Lefty. I'll miss him.
You couldn't stand Lefty. You once poked him in the eye with a number 3 socket spanner.
Exactly! Good times.
Spin the Bottle Championship is coming up.
I like when they do the sudden death round with the Molotov cocktails.
Do you like taking in some pro wrestling?
I think I've seen that one.
We should go to Switzerland sometime, Max.
Nah, they always jip you on the cheese. It's like half air.
Hey, it's the Indie Angst Film Festival.
What do? Show that second movie over and over again?
Well, the number plate on that car said drug dealer. Well. Okay. Sybil's changed her profession again. Tabloid rag.
Nice cactus. Saguaro?
Vinyl.
Hey, if you dip that in ink, you could do 30 tattoos at once!
If I could scare up 30 customers at once, I'd still be in the tattoo business.
This appears to be some sort of reproductive device.
It's a mimeograph. I use it to print my tabloid.
She's got a story here about 2 hygienists from Walla Walla and an amorphous Saturnian slime mold.
Is that the one where they walk into a bar at the beginning?
Laundromat. But you're close.
And one thing I forgot to do, it was to look in the closets back in the office, but I will return there shortly.
Sam! Max! How nice to see you! I don't suppose you have any candid photos of little green men feeling frisky, do you?
Yes. By which I mean, huh?
It's my new career. I'm a tabloid publisher specializing in the thoughtful analysis of groundbreaking news of interest to myself and others like me.
What's it called?
The Alien Love Triangle Times.
So you're a publisher now? What happened to psychotherapy?
I've always had a fascination with the suppressed and the sensual, and for telling people too much about both. Publishing the Alien Love Triangle Times is a logical extension of all my previous careers. Except maybe Vatican spokesperson.
Are you doing any psychotherapy on the side?
Only on space aliens.
I guess that narrows your clientele quite a bit.
No, not really.
How about a quick analysis, for old time's sake?
Oh, all right. Think of a number between 1 and 4.
3.5.
You're harboring feelings of guilt over previous feelings of remorse.
That's so true. How about another quick analysis?
Oh, all right. Think of a number between 1 and 4.
1.
You're selectively audio-averse.
I don't like the sound of that.
Oh, God.
How about another quick analysis?
Oh, all right. Think of a number between 1 and 4.
2.
Sounds like inverse paranoia to me.
What don't you mean by that?
Mm-hmm. I thought so.
How about another quick analysis?
Oh, all right. Think of a number between 1 and 4.
3.
You have boundless apeirophobia.
What's that?
The usual.
What was it you said about a photo?
My new tabloid, the Alien Love Triangle Times, needs a cover photo of an extraterrestrial biological entity, or alien as the unwashed masses calls them, caught getting cozy with some of the locals.
Sybil, I'd like the record to show that although I support you as a friend, your latest project makes my skin decidedly crawly.
Me too, and I like it.
So, you're looking for a cover photo of little green men canoodling, right?
Yeah, though I'm kind of desperate at this point. Basically, I can use anything as long as there are 3 beings in the shot and at least one of them's an alien. It is the Alien Love Triangle Times, after all.
Got it. So, you're looking for a cover photo of little green men canoodling, right?
Yeah, though I'm kind of desperate at this point. Things in the...
Got it.
Yeah, anyway.
There's nothing like good, hard-nosed journalism.
You said it. It's time to find out the real answers to the real questions.
Like what did those poor cattle do to deserve that?
No. What do aliens do for romance? Do they love? How do they get their otherworldly thrills?
By playing slots in Keno? That'd explain why they're always seen in Nevada.
Have you learned anything interesting since you started this, magazine?
I learned why Elvis had such an otherworldly voice.
Elvis was not an alien.
Sure he was. He just wore makeup to cover his emerald green skin.
Frankly, Sybil, this project is disturbing, as well as distressingly intimate.
Like seeing Stephen King getting a hot butter massage.
Oh, you saw last week's issue.
Is anybody else an alien that we might not know about?
Dr. Phil.
Well, that goes without saying. Is anybody else an alien that we might not know about?
Yes.
Okay.
We'll be back.
Keep watching the supplies.
Quick trip to the office, and then we'll head to the TV studio. If I remember correctly, in each new episode, there's something, a little memento that's left in the closet in the next episode. There we go.
Ah, Brady Culture's hair. It makes for an unwieldy but oh-so-enchanting memento of our first case in a long while.
He howled like a sick wallaby when I shaved it off him. Good times.
Anybody home? Guess not.
Right. Let's become actors.
Mr. Spatula.
Isn't he plastic?
Mr. Spatula's looking good today.
Isn't he plastic? Where are we going, Sam?
The TV studio.
Goody!
Right, now we're here. It's almost time. So when I return, we will see Sam and Max do some acting. But for now, take care. See you soon. Bye-bye.